Obeying the Gospel, November 21st. Have we put on Christ? For as many of you as were baptized into Christ have put on Christ. Galatians 3:27. In the New Testament, one way Christians are described is to say that they are people who have put on Christ. The image, of course, is that of taking off one set of clothes and putting on another. In his new relationship with Jesus Christ, the Christian has put on his Lord. He has adopted Christ's virtues and character in such a way as to have clothed himself in Christ. First, baptized into Christ. Paul wrote that as many of you as were baptized into Christ have put on Christ. Attempts to explain away this clear statement are futile. It is in baptism, and not before, that we enter into this new relationship with Christ, not because it earns us salvation as a meritorious work, but simply because Christ commanded it as a condition of His grace, Acts 2:38. But second, putting on Christ. Baptism is followed by the living of a new life, Romans 6, verse 4. So there's a link between baptism and putting on Christ. But the second does not automatically follow from the first. It's a choice on the part of the one who has been baptized. For that reason, the Christian is not just said to have put on Christ, as in Galatians 3:27, but he is commanded to do so, Ephesians 4, verse 24. In Colossians 2, verse 6, Paul put it simply, "Therefore, as you received Christ Jesus the Lord, so walk in Him." Suppose a person studies Jesus' teachings and emulates His character, but does not obey the command to be baptized for the remission of his sins. He'll have a better life in this world, and others will benefit from that. But he'll die with no scriptural basis upon which to expect anything but separation from God in eternity. But turn the situation around. Suppose a person is baptized, but he never chooses to put on Christ. His lifestyle would suggest that, despite his baptism, his heart still belongs to the devil. His old rebellious self was not buried as it should have been, as Paul says in Romans 6, verses 1 through 4. So for those who have been baptized, the critical question is, have we put on Christ? Have we been truly converted to Him, discarding our old life and clothing ourselves with the fresh, clean garments of our Lord's heart, mind, and character? If not, perhaps our commitment to Christ is lacking. He deserves better from us. Samuel Wilberforce made this comment, "Christianity can be condensed into four words: admit, submit, commit, and transmit."